Be like a Momo dumpling, plain and simple outside, awesome and amazing inside, quote unquote Anjuman.
So we are doing a comparison video of momos, the most expensive, the least expensive and the most value for money. So we are here today at JW Marriott and we're going to be trying out momos from Vintage Asia. That is the place which is serving the most expensive momos available in Kolkata right now. So we had to be here. That's the first stop of the day. So let's get inside. Alright guys, so this is your host Shabaz Zaman and we are at the first stop of the day, which is Vintage Asia in Marriott. Let's quickly get inside and show you what the place looks like first. So you might have a question, why are we doing a comparison video? And there might be a lot of comparison videos already. What we wanted to do was, first of all, compare momos, because momos are extremely popular and people love momos. So we had to compare different types of momos which are available, not by the kinds, but different prices, which the various price segments which are available. So what we're going to do is we're going to compare one which is served at a 5-star like Marriott, a place which is going to be serving the cheapest roadside stall. And finally, we're going to be going for something which is going to be in between the two, but it's going to be value for money, which is very popular in Kolkata. We've done a lot of these polls, etc. on Foods for coming into this particular video. So we're going to be comparing all and we're going to tell you what according to us is the best fit, because everything has a different kind of a requirement. Sometimes ambience is very important, which is why we decided on sitting at a place and experiencing it and not just ordering it at home, because ambience plays a very key role depending on the mood and the occasion. So we're going to be comparing the ambience, we'll be seeing the prices, the quality of the ingredients which are used, the taste and everything else which is possible in a plate of momo.
It's all
dim sum
chili.
Oh, I couldn't tell me which one is what.
This is sauce and this is burnt garlic.
Okay.
This is the green chili.
Alright.
And this is the sweet chili dip. This is a Thai chili. This is a little spicy.
Okay.
And this is the chiu chow chili dip. This is our most popular actually.
Is it very spicy?
This is not spicy. This is actually look like it's a hot spicy, but this is not spicy.
We have the momo at Vintage Asia. This is the box which it comes in. And this is your Shanghai chicken dumpling. This is what it looks like. You can see a crispy layer on the bottom. It's a little greasy on the top. It's a paper thin layer. And you can see it's translucent, so you can see the insides. A lot of vegetables and a lot of meat inside. So this is what it looks like. So they've given three pieces. So I'm going to use my hands because there's no way I'm going to do justice to this comparison if I'm not using my hands. So I'll break this open on camera. So this is what it looks like inside. You see, it has a lot of juice and oil in it. Even if there's a fair proportion of meat and vegetables, there's a lot of meat inside. But I think what's going to matter is what it tastes like inside my mouth. Wow, it's got a certain tanginess inside because it has vinegar in it. It's called a ginger vinegar dumpling. It's crispy outside, very flavorful, a good mix of chicken and veggies like I've mentioned. Even without the dips, it tastes pretty good. But since there are so many sauces available, like the famous quotation goes, memories without pictures is like momos without sauce. We have a lot of options for sauce over here. I'm going to take this one because this seems pretty unique. I'm going to take this. I'm going to dip my already disintegrating momo. I'm going to dip it with a little bit of the sauce. so that it amalgamates into one cohesive mouthful of dumplings. This is amazing. Right, so we are done with the first stop of the day. We are done with the most expensive. We're starting with most expensive. And this is the bill which we've been given, the check. So the dumpling which we had over here, that comes for $5.95. If you add taxes, it comes up to $702. So for three pieces, we're coming up to 234 rupees a piece. Which, just judging by the promo, obviously it's not going to be value for money at all. But when you keep into consideration the entire ambience and the service which you get, and not to mention the cashews and the crisps which they give by the side, definitely if it's an occasion which calls for special arrangement, then definitely this is worth it. And of course the taste, the burst of flavor and everything else, everything included, it was a pretty good deal if you're looking for such things and not just the momo. So that was our experience at Vintage Asia. Over to our next stop. A little bit of history behind momos. So this is basically a dish which was invented in the Southeastern Asian region. And the chief ingredient obviously used to be non-vegetarian, but as it developed popularity in mostly India, so it the requirement of getting a vegetarian version of the same increased, and that is when we discovered different types of momos with different types of fillings, etc., including vegetarian. Alright guys, so we are at 8B Jadavpur, and this is the very famous spot we've been recommended, which is right below Canara Bank. Alright, so at the price of 45 rupees, they're giving 5 pieces. For 45, I'm gonna take one. I'm gonna break this open on camera. So this is what the filling, the stuffing looks like from inside, and that's my bite. Honestly, I did not expect this to be so juicy. Priced at 45 rupees. For 5, that's 9 rupee piece. One where we were previously, that was 232 rupees a piece. 34, sorry. Along with the soup, the sauce, everything. This is an amazing deal. So that was our experience at the cheapest momos in town, 45 rupees. I'm told that she sells around 200 momos every day, and this is approximately a 16-year-old stall. So it's a pretty good one, pretty good deal, and it was definitely prices worth. You don't have a lot of ambience, etc., but the momo, if you're comparing it by just the momo, it was tasting pretty good, costing around 9 rupees a piece. Worth try. This is very close to Jadavpur University. If you haven't tried it already, you can definitely give it a try. So this is a plate of chicken momo from Denzong. They've given 6 pieces, so finally we get an even number. So I'm gonna take one first and break it in front of you. Now this is what I was waiting for. As you can see, I'll just show you one more. Just wait for it. You see the amount of oil which gushes out the moment you break open into one.
is amazing. This is a speciality of Denzong momos, which is why people flock these places. Like, it has a lot of outlets in Kolkata and all of it are very popular. So I'm gonna try it with the famous chutney of this momo. So that was our experience at all three outlets. The most expensive, which was Vintage Asia, the cheapest, which was Jadavpur 80, and the most value for money, which according to me is Denzong all the time. Any of the outlets which you visit, I visited All Green outlet because it was convenient to park the car, but any of the outlets which you go to, it tastes the same. When you're comparing the momos, if you look at ambience and the entire experience, then of course nothing beats Vintage Asia. If you're looking for extremely reasonable option, someone who has a limited budget like college going students or school going students, then definitely Jadavpur 8B. And if you have a little bit more of a budget and if you want to have the best momos possible within definitely a reasonable amount of money, then Denzong is one of the best options. The entire purpose of making this video was fun. So I do not wish to get into any kind of comparisons because it will not be fair, because all of them are priced differently. So that's like the major reason, the major comparison which can come. So since they are priced very differently, there is actually no comparison. Forcefully, when you're trying to get into the other criterias, then only can you compare. But that was not my purpose at all. I wanted to basically just show you what this place looks like and what the momos taste like. Also, if you have not subscribed to the channel yet, please do subscribe to the channel. If you're enjoying the contents which we're making, do share them, comment, recommend us places or the kind of different series which you would want us to do. This particular series was also recommended to us by our subscribers themselves. So if you want more such contents, do let us know in the comment section below. Until next time, this is Foodspan myself wrapping up from Golf Green. Cheers. Next stop is going to be Denzong Kitchen. এইভাবে এটা করবি, এখান থেকে আমরা যখন আসবো এখানে ভিন্টেজ এশিয়ার দিকে তো বাইরেটা আছে, ওইখানে আমরা করবো, অথবা এই একটা অপশন আছে এইখান থেকে যখন ইটস রেইনিং অ্যাগেন পরে দুটো শুট কিরম করে করবো। Alright guys, so we are doing a comparison video.